was not built in a day. Time factor is necessary. When you dwell from day to day, you will become conscious of that light and the music of the spheres that is reverberating throughout all creation. So that will come in due course like that. But for that we have to work. So mind that one does not become a satsangi, a truly initiate, simply by being given the context. You see? Of course, some experience is necessary to start with. If you have got no experience, that cannot be developed. So fortunate you are that with the grace of God, you all of you have some contact with that thing. Now that we have to develop so much so that even while sleeping, working and anywhere, you will always be conscious of that. So actions speak louder than words. Thoughts are even more potent. You are not to tell that such and such, I mean, flower is very fragrant. Let flower give out, emit that fragrance, and let others say that flower is fragrant. Let your lives prove that you have got something higher. Otherwise, these things are already existing in our scriptures. Knowing something is not becoming something. Knowing means just having in your brains, in your memory, something such and such, scripture says such and such. But that does not really give you anything unless you live up to them, and the people will judge only by your actions, what you speak. Even your thoughts are potent than that, because thoughts radiate. If you have got loving thoughts, those thoughts will radiate love. You see in the lives of the saints, events have been coming, have been seen, in which even the snakes would not go to harm them. In the story of Guru Nanak, he was lying under a tree, his whole body was, I mean, love personified and love overflowed. Flowed his body. He was just lying under a tree and he was in meditation. And the tree's sun was just changed and the shadow which was over his head also changed. Now there was sun rays on his face. A cobra came up, just stood in a way so that there should be no rays of the sun fall on his face. The ruler of the place passed by that. He thought Nanak had been dead. Because the snake is there, he must have bitten him. And when he went near him, the snake went away and the Guru Nanak was alive. Why? The love radiates from our lives, you see. We had a similar event in our satsang meetings at Delhi. There were about 2,000 people were sitting. While I was giving a talk, one cobra, little cobra came and stood on the stage like that, just like that in front of you. And the people said, here's the cobra coming, okay, never mind, go on with it, let it come, stand. And that cobra stood for one full hour, hearing what the talk was going on, looking at me. When the talk was over, he sneaked away. And the people said, let us kill him. Why he has not just told you anything? Why you kill him? So this is all what is meant to say. If you have love for all, even the snakes won't harm you. You see, we have got proverb, be wise like snakes. Snakes are very wise, why that? They at once catch the radiation. What thoughts are radiated from you. When you see a snake or killing, the very thought goes out and he safeguards himself by attacking. You have no evil thought for anybody, they won't do any harm to you. So I am telling you, thoughts are more potent. Now you'll find an ounce of practice in more than tons of theories. What use is to know the principles if one does not live up to them? You say, tell the truth, if you don't tell the truth, then. You say, love others, don't think of others, evil of others, and you still think evil of others, what is the use of knowing that? That's a holding some information in your brain. Such and such, scripture says such and such, such and such, master says such and such. Well, what is that to you? We should learn to live up to them. A learned man with no practice, he is no better than a beast of burden carrying a load of books or scriptures. That's all. So it is infinitely better to practice than to preach. Must live than say. Otherwise, you may be a scholar. You may have written commentaries on certain subjects. They may be very, in a religious way, outwardly. You read scriptures, tell others, preach others, and do not live up to them, then what is it? Truly such like preaching does not carry any effect. The arrow which is drawn to the chest only goes to the target. What words come out of our heart as we live up to it, they carry effect by radiation to others' heart. I remember of a case, one man came to Gandhi. One mother brought his little child. He said, this child eats the sugar too much. Then Gandhi told him, all right, mother, bring this child after 3 days. He went away. And she came after 3 days. Then he told, well, child, don't eat sugar. And the mother said, well, Gandhi, if you have to say that much only, why didn't you say it that day? He said, because I was eating sugar then. Mind that if you don't live up to what you say, those words don't carry any effect. So whatever thoughts are in our hearts, any words we give out, those come at charge with those very things what already is there. If a man openly is very good man, and his heart is full of passions, he is now living up to what the scriptures say, naturally whatever words will he utter, those may be very sweet words will carry that very effect, like heat. And if there are the heaps of ice there, and you put a blanket over it, which does not appear to be very good, even then any wind that strikes that heap of apparently covered by a black blanket, that will give you cold. You follow my point? This is what is required. This is just like a petal passing, a spoon passing through a sweet dish. That tablespoon or spoon does not have any taste. This is just like the persons who have got so much knowledge at the intellectual level, but they don't live up to them. So, as I told you, an ounce of practice is more than tons of theories. This is the one thing. And above all, I will say, as I told you before, a pure heart is most essential for spiritual progress. You cannot expect a king to enter a filthy cavern. Even a dog does not sit in an unclean place. He He just cleans the place with his tail, you see. How can you expect God to appear in a heart full of passions, greed, pride, attachment, or egotism? So you'll have to keep that pure and simple, you see, a loving heart for all, helping hand for all, you see. So for that reason, we should live up to what the scriptures say. Try to never to harm the feelings of others. If a blind man is there, you tell him, oh blind man, he feels it. If you just sit by him, dear friend, how did you lose your sight? Purpose is the same. The little words carry much effect. These very words go to work like a consolation. The very words go to flare up. So for that reason, we must live up to what we say. If we live up to that, what would the result? When you speak, speak in the most kind and gentle manner. Don't lose temper over anything. Already keep your tongue under control. Eat, this is one thing. The wound given by a sword will be healed in a month or so. But the wound given by tongue is not healed. All through life, ever you remember again, that becomes afresh. So these are the things that we have to just look after all. The man who has got the birth, man, body, he has the birthright to see God. We can change, especially when we are helped by others, those who are competent to give us help, who take you in their charge, who have goodwill for you, not for you, but for your souls. They look to the all the world over from the angle of the God in them. They see all as the children of God, as their own children. Guru Nanak, when he left his heart and home to carry this message of God to the world at large, he had two children and wife. The mother-in-law came up and told, well, Nanak, what are you doing? Why are you leaving your family? He said, all humanity is my family. They give from that, see that, from that level. Masters are there. They are overflowing with the love of God and love for all humanity. They take up this role as given by God, you see. Otherwise, in their old age, why should they be going around for this, for no purpose, no selfish motive? They have got only one motive, to just bring all children of God back to God. That's all. They don't need any payment. Their talks are given free. They live on their own earnings. They are not a burden to anybody else. So when they say something, they say out of their love for all. So this is what is wanted. So I tell you the story of one prince. He left his heart, home, to become a saint. His name was Gopichand. He went to his master. So master, what he told, there are ways and ways of the master, that was a yogi master, you see. He said, all you leave all your whole heart and home and come here. He sent him to just, because they have nothing to eat, live on, go and bring alms from their homes. But he advised them first to go to their own family, to his own wife, then to his others, mother and everybody. He went to his wife, begging. She said, now my husband is gone, what all these things for? I'm left alone. She gave all arguments what she had. Then he came to his mother. And mother said, because he took up that way of life under the advice of his mother. Some mothers are very, you see, spiritual. They wish their children to be godly. So she advised his son to take up that spiritual way. So what he said, well, look here, I will give you three advices to live. First is, you must always remain in a strong fort. And Gopichand asked his mother, Mother, there's no place to live in. Sometimes we'll have to pass our nights on the roadside. How you say that I should live in castles always, in very strong fortresses? Then she explained to him, look here, live always under the custody of your master. That's a very strong fort, mind that. Master is one at whose pole God is manifest and radiates his protection and love even from thousands of miles. If you can catch the voice from thousands of miles through radios, why can't you have the radiation from a man pole at whom God is working? By radiation you can have. That means live where you are, maybe near or far. Always think that God power, mind that. God is the true master. In whatever human pole he is manifested, that manifested God is the true master who pervades all creation. When you come under the custody of such a God in man or man in God, well, when he initiates you, he resides with you. Always, never forget him. The more you think of, as you think, so you become. And that reacts in the heart whom you remember. That gives you receptivity. That gives you quicker results. You can have that radiation even near or far. Kabir says, if your master is living beyond seven seas and you living this side, direct your attention towards him, you will have radiation and effect. So this is the first, advice which mother gave to Gopichand. And the second was advice, always sleep on very soft and very, nice and elegant beds. Then again, Gopichand told his mother, well, mother, there's no place to sleep there. We might have to sleep on stones and on earth. How can you say we can have very fine beds, very soft beds? Then she told him, well, look here, don't go to sleep unless sleep overtakes you. When sleep overtakes you, there's no question you are lying on the stones or the earth or in a bed. These are the advices given by his mother to his son. And the third thing he said, well, always what to do? You eat very best dishes, very delicious dishes. Then again he asked his mother, well, dear mother, how can we be just begging alms? Somebody will give us dry. Sometimes we won't get even to eat. How you say we should always have very rich diet? Very delicious dishes. Then mother told him, look here, don't eat unless you feel very hungry. You see? Very hungry. When you are very hungry, even the grams you eat, that give you taste. So these are the three advices given by the mother of Gopichand to his son. If you live up to that, you'll find how much good it carries. You live up to the sayings of the masters. They say, have pure lives. He says, let your earnings be honest. He says, just have good lives, good thoughts, good words and good deeds. And he says, always have the sweet memories of God. So these are the three instructions which were given by the mother of Gopichand to live a life. You'll find never step out of the commandments what the master say. So if you just carry out and live within the four walls of the teachings of the masters, you will develop from day to day. So what he says further, he says, silence is golden. Speak as little as possible. Silence is golden. So daily find some period of silence. And night is the best portion of that. Then Guru of the Sikhs tells us what? Night is your just lonely place. Those who have just utilized their nights, they have become saints, they have become gods. And the students have become scholars. The best use of the night. Though they have spoiled their nights, they have just spoiled their lives, you see. You see, we have got all these shows, companies, and other engagements at night, up to 11, 12, 1, 2. Well, how can such a man can progress in any way? A student who has burnt the midnight oil, he becomes a scholar. A lover of God who has put in nights in the best remembrance of God, taking that all solitude, he becomes a saint. Sometimes we simply for enjoyment's sake waste time, kill time. And we complain we have got no time. Out of 24 hours you find how much time you put into your daily earning. Say 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours. Not more in any case. We have got even 12 hours at our disposal. Give to sleep, say, 5 hours, 6 hours. Then 6 hours with you. Give more 2 hours to your eating, drinking, this and that. Then you got 4 hours at your disposal. When the people say we have got no time, they have to adjust themselves. Time has not to come from anywhere else. That is already there and we have to adjust ourselves that thing. As I told you, truth is above all, and true living is still about truth. So people, man is known only by the how they find you. If you are true, you are helping, you are good, you set a good example, the others follow you. They do not even give you credit, but give the credit to the school to which you belong, to the master with whom you are connected. So, for that there is one principle to be followed. That principle is, perform no action in secret except prayers. If anything requires secrecy, abandon at once. And deeds of darkness are always committed in the dark. Do nothing which after being done lead you to tell lies. But don't desire evil for anyone irrespective of creed or color, even in thought, word and deed. Because thoughts are more potent, you see. To help some poor person and he is in all and do not hurt anyone by word, indeed. These are the things which go to help us. Always think that God power is residing within you and watching your every action. First thing. And secondly, don't transcend the commandments given by Him to live up to. If you do like that, like Kabir says, you are not too afraid in the three worlds. Here and hereafter. To all these things are to be just devote time morning and evening to your practices and fully just as a child who has no wisdom, simply out of love, go to the lap of the father and the mother. Leave off all your wisdom and everything aside. Go lovingly. So these are the things in the evening remain. Review your evil daily life and just like a strict judge, try to weed out all imperfections you have from day to day. The secret of success in the path is practice, more practice, and still more practice. You see, practice makes a man. What is the way to concentration? Well, there is no high road to a concentration. The only high road is concentrate, concentrate, and concentrate. For that very purpose, these diaries for self-introspection have been prescribed. That will make you regular. That will just bring to your notice any shortcomings that you have in your life. What you know, when you know there are so many scorpions and snakes under, sitting under the seat, my seat, naturally you want to clean them up. So you have to weed out these things from day to day. So for that reason, what should we do? Keep a diary. That is very helping factor, I tell you. That can make a saint out of robbers. So man can change. There's hope for everybody. Every saint has his past and every sinner a future. So mind that, see no evil, hear no evil, talk no evil, and think no evil. If you follow these things, you'll find progress from day to day. I wish each one of you to become ambassadors of truth. But that you can become only when you live up to it, what you say. And these diaries are meant with a very noble purpose. So that is why you'll find I have prescribed diaries for self-introspection under certain heads, truthfulness, no harm, non-violence, thought, word and deed, chastity, you see, the underlying principle, and love for all. Those are meant for your own purpose so that you may know what are the shortcomings in you, and further to weed out one by one. And they are sent to me only for the purpose of guidance for the way necessary. Because Rome was not built in a day. Time factor is necessary. So, as I told you, these are few are the words which come out of my heart to you all whom I dear the most. You are all more dear to me than my sons. My own family. I wish you progress spiritually. You got the man body by the grace of God, and by the grace of God, you have been given a contact with God that you have to dwell with due regard to the self-introspection, which will just come up by keeping regular diaries sent to me at regular intervals, say quarterly. If you live up to it, everything will be cleared, I tell you honestly. If you sit by fire, well, all cold will go. If you sit by ice, all heat will go. If your soul comes in contact with the light and sound principle, all doubts will go. Doubts and other things arise because we don't live up to what we say. I wish you progress. This is the highest thing that I had in my life, with the grace of God and through the grace of the God working through my Master, that I have passed unto you with His grace. Live up to them and derive the full benefit which God has given you, a golden opportunity to have it. But my real pleasure will go to you when you live up to that. You may be proud of me, but I will be proud of you only if you want. You will become what I want. I want each one of you to become like myself or even more than me, I would say. This is the truth that has been given to you. Well, live up to that. Don't be misguided. All scriptures tell us that what has been given to you and experience thereof with the grace of God. If you find anything puzzling to you, you will please write to me. If I find that truth is more than what has been given to you, I will also follow you. This is what my master used to say. He says, the truth has been given to you. If you find any more truth, you take up and tell me, I will also go. We are after truth, you see. So, and thank you all. You can meet me tomorrow or today for leaving. My best wishes will always remain with you.